Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we're looking at another new plugin today for the fantastic Divi theme. It's called Divi Plus, and I'll put the link below the video. And I've just created these various different modules in no time at all, and they've got some wonderful little modules. They've got a sort of compare. They've got some great breadcrumbs here. We've got some conversion buttons with nice overlay effects. We've got a sort of content slider where you can have two sets of content and flip between the two. So I've got text and an image there. We've got some Facebook embeds here. We can embed just a post, embed the whole channel here, which is all live, or embed a Facebook video. We got some fancy headlines. We got some masked headlines. I always like to see that. They're great. We got some flip boxes and cube boxes. We got a floating image next door to that. We got hotspot images with tooltips and links. We got a great little timeline here, which you don't see those too often in plugins. We got some great card modules with icons. And the one we're going to look at today is our Masonry gallery right here. We've also got some image hovers. That's a nice little effect where you can hover over the image and see detailed elements of it without zooming in too much. And we've got image accordions. And another great feature is modal pop-up boxes. And that's great. And I've only scratched the surface there. So let's have a look at this gallery here. Let's add a new page. And we'll call it gallery, funnily enough. And I'm going to use the Divi builder. Okay, I'm going to build from scratch. I'm going to put one column in, one row. Now Divi comes with all these light gray ones here. Plenty enough to build just about any site. When you add Divi Plus, you get all these ones with a DP in front of them. And the one I'm looking for today is the Masonry gallery. There it is right there. And it's really easy to use, like most gallery modules. Just simply hit the Add Gallery Image button. Select all the image. You can select multiples at once that you want to use on your site. When you're happy, just hit the Select button. And it'll start adding them to your module here. And like most gallery modules, you can just drag and replace and put things in where you actually want them on your site here. And instantly, we've got a nice little gallery there, which is great. Now, if we look down a little bit, we'll close the config and we'll look into elements. You can enable lightbox if you want to them to pop up in large image. You can show the titles if you choose to. I'm going to leave mine off, and you can show captions if you choose. You can put an image overlay on hover if you want. I guess if that's using captions, as you can see, it's added one in there and a little icon. So let's perhaps put a magnifying glass in there to indicate that there's going to be a larger image. You can link the module to anywhere you want. I don't particularly want to do that. I don't particularly want to put a background in at the moment. I'm happy with that as it is. If we move over to our design tab, you can change your text and caption titles there. Obviously font weights and font sizes and everything that you can usually change with text. If we go into the lightbox settings. Now when it pops out into a lightbox one, when you click on it, background color you've got here, I'm going to leave mine pretty much on default here. You can set the close icon and the arrows also. We'll demonstrate this in a minute. Overlay, we've got our overlay color there. And title and caption background color, but I haven't got those on at the moment. Here's our overlay icon color. I'm going to make that white. Let's make our background perhaps purple. There we go, that's fine. And if you want to add transparency, it's got a hex number there. You can simply put a number from 00 up to 99 in there. 00 meaning you'll see all the way through it. 99 meaning it'll be almost fully colored like it is at the moment. So I'm going to say 60. And there you can see some of the image behind there now. Yeah, that's great. That's going to work for me. Sizing, I don't want to change anything there. I'm happy for it to be full width. Module alignment in the middle, that's fine too. Let's go back to our content. And if we look in the configuration, you can change the number of columns. Let's change this to 3 perhaps. You can change the image size when they pop. So I'm going to make mine large. If we go into the elements, we looked at this earlier, and I'm happy with my little icon that I've got there. So I think I've got everything I need for my little gallery right here. And how quick was that? So let's save our changes, just have a look down. Yeah, that's fine. Save draft or publish if you're ready. And let's exit the Visual Builder. Now there's our little overlay with our little icon to indicate that we can zoom in on it. And there's the light box image. Here's the background, light box background color. Here's our close icon. And here are our arrows. And you can style and change the color of any of these. So there you have it. There is one very quick and easy masonry gallery. We're using the new Divi Plus for this today. So I hope you've enjoyed this and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.